for continuous improvement and assessment, and I'm very pleased to be here tonight with a team presenting some information for you on Beckley Charter School. So I want to recognize that one of the team here speaking, but also, we also have several members in the audience that can also jump in and add anything to the conversation. Alright, so tonight, the purpose of our report is to provide you with information prior to bringing a recommendation regarding an action item to the school board around the renewal contract for Pathways Charter School. So tonight, what we're going to do is share some information with you. I first want to really thank Becky and Anton for, they are the coordinators and also teachers, and so they just really stepped up and taken the lead. It's just been great to work with them on this. I also want to just thank the Pathways Governance Council. We had several meetings, probably more of the Governance Council, and Becky and Anton, but our last few conversations have been just great. And some of them are here today, tonight, so I really just thank them for their engagement and conversation to move forward together. In addition, Tim Stelmacher has served as our liaison for Pathways, and so he's attended some of the meetings, so that's just also help the partnership. So thank you on behalf of the whole team. So tonight, like I said, we're going to be sharing information with you. The first piece of information we wanted to share with you is that there is a desire for a continued contract between the school district and Pathways Charter School. Becky and Anton are going to share a little bit more about the general overview of Pathways Charter School. Since some of you are new board members, it would just be good time to just stop and reflect and come back to what is Pathways Charter School, what does it stand for, you know, how is it doing. We're also going to spend a little bit of time just showing you how the students are served throughout the day. And then we're going to get a parent perspective real quick, and then also talk about Pathways Charter School accountability. There's a couple different pieces that we wanted to share around that. And then Laura will end with next steps.
So, like Jen said, my name is Becky Drumline. I'm one of the co-lead teachers at Pathways, and I'm also the math teacher at Pathways. I've been with Pathways since it opened in 2013, so this is my fifth year here.
Anton Bowser, one of the other co-lead teacher and the social studies teacher there, and I've been, this is my second year with Pathways.
So we would just like to share a little bit of information with you because we know that many of you might not exactly know what Pathways is or what we do on a daily basis, so just to give you some background knowledge on all of that. So we are a 7th grade through 12th grade project-based learning school. We are located in the Mutual Mall right on Main Street across from Aldi's. We have 4 teachers, 1 secretary, and 1 counselor that work with us on a weekly basis. Our enrollment right now is at 58 students, 7th grade through 12th grade, and our students spend their time at the high school. For those students that are in high school, they take their electives at the high school. Those students in middle school take their electives at Badger, and they take their core subjects with us at Pathways. Pathways in its development, Pathways has always been part of the research and development arm of the district, and we'll talk about some of those things that we've done as well. But the research and development we've done includes things like one-to-one technology. We are part of the rollout and implementation of that, part of the rollout and implementation of individualized and personalized learning, and mentoring some of the other schools and teachers in the district that are working towards those things too. So part of what we want to share with you today is what a day in the life of a Pathway student looks like. So what is to be expected if a student comes to Pathways? So the schedule for a Pathway student is a little bit different in the middle school versus in the high school. So a 7th or 8th grade student at Pathways will start their day at Badger Middle School taking their electives. So they may take gym or band or art, things like that. And then they'll take a shuttle bus over to Pathways where they get all four of their core subject areas. So students start their day off in advisory. Advisory is a time where we do a lot of community building, team building. We do a lot of career exploration. So part of what we do at Pathways is that we are a career-based school. So students are researching different careers and exploring the different career clusters in order to figure out where they want to go post-secondary. Students are also working on passion projects, and we also use that time to get guest speakers and community members to come in and support us as well. Then they also have their content, the core content areas, so a math workshop or a science workshop, things like that. They're with us for lunch. Then every day we have a different area of content extension, so we do a little bit of extension in every core subject area once per week. And then more workshops in the afternoon, and then they take their shuttle bus back to Badger so that they can take their bus home. It's a pretty similar schedule in the 9th through 12th grade. Students start their day off at the high school taking their electives, similar things of foreign language, art, band, and gym. And then they take a shuttle to Pathways, where at the high school level, our students are in an environment that's very much of a business-like setting. So our students are learning how to work individually, independently, how to advocate for themselves, how to manage their own time, and work on their own individualized projects. So students are working individually, but seeking out one-on-one instruction from a coach. They also have scheduled guided workshops that they kind of set up like a meeting. So you have a meeting at 12:30, and then students are expected to manage their own time and make sure they show up for that meeting. Again, they're with us for lunch, and in the afternoon, they have a very similar schedule. So this flexible schedule and the flexibility we have at Pathways to incorporate a lot of these different skills and career clusters and employability skills meets the needs of a lot of the students in our district that are looking for something a little bit different. And as far as meeting the needs of those students in the district that are looking for something else, in order to give you a more real world kind of story, we do have a parent here as well that is taking time to share with you the story of her students that have been at Pathways. So I'd like to welcome Diana Spillinger, and she can come on up here and give us her perspective as well.
Thank you, Becky. It's a privilege to be here with all of you. My name is Diana Spillinger. I have four kids one just graduated, three currently in the district. I've been the parent representative on the Pathways Governance Council since 2013. I'll give you a cliff note version of I've had two students at Pathways, and this is the story of my older son.